is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will not forget your love for me, and yet my heart forever is wandering. Jesus, be my guide, hold me closely to your side, and I will love you to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. You're the light unto my path.
Evening, folks, welcome to our evening reflection for today. It's Sunday the 24th of September, and it's good to be with you. We're continuing our walk through the verses of Psalm 23, that beautiful, well-known psalm, and just reflecting on what each of those verses might say to us. What it says to me might say something different to what they say to you. I'd love to hear your thoughts on some of these verses. Today we've reached the second part of verse 3, so we've been going a little while, we've been taking it slow. Today we're reading this: He guides me along the right paths. He guides me along the right paths. He leads me in the right path. I wonder what that verse means for you. Let's pray. Loving God, thank you for this beautiful psalm. We pray, Lord, as we just reflect on it now, you'd speak to each one of us of what it means to be led in your paths. In Jesus' name, amen. A year or so ago now, Pam and I were walking in the Picos Mountains in northern Spain. It's the most beautiful place, just towering limestone hills and cliffs and just stunning, stunning scenery. One of the days walking we did was through, apparently, I mean, I didn't know it at the time, but one of the most famous walks in Spain, through a place called the Jerez Gorge. The Jerez Gorge is, well, rightly stunning. But the path through it is extremely narrow. There's a small path cut in the hills. On one side of you, there's a very steep drop, getting up to, in some parts, at least 200-300 feet. And to your other side, as you're walking along this path, there's a towering cliff going up. So you're sandwiched between this cliff on one side and a steep drop on the other side. In fact, we've got a little video. This is Pam walking along the Jerez Gorge. Just have a watch of this. I mean, goodness me, it makes me, every time I watch it, and I was there filming Pam from behind. We were all right, actually, walking along that path until somebody came the other way. And when somebody came the other way, you suddenly had to decide, which side am I going to stand to let them pass? Or which side are they going to stand to allow me to pass? And the closer I got to the edge, the less confident I became. Sometimes the paths that we take in life are challenging paths. Sometimes it's not clear which path we need to take. The Bible says a lot about different paths. In Jeremiah, God offers ancient paths and good paths, but we don't always choose to take those paths. Often we feel like we're standing at a crossroads. One way looks obvious that the other we're uncertain of. We're never really sure whether we're on the right path or not. Robert Frost famously wrote a poem that said, "Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less travelled by, and that has made all the difference." The only way we can be sure of being on the right path is to follow the way of Christ. Psalm 119 says this, it says, "Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." For many years I took that word as being the word of Scripture, that I had to follow the word of Scripture diligently. And then I found difficulty in understanding exactly what Scripture was trying to say, because one path might say this, one path might say that. Then I realised that the word you and I are called to follow, the one that provides light for our feet, is the one who is also the way, is the living word, Jesus. We're called to follow a path that Christ has trod before. He well knows the way of righteousness, the way of holiness, the way of mercy and justice. The way of Christ is a path less travelled, but it's a good path. It leads us to streams of abundance, to places of living water, to pastures where we might lie down and be fed. And in the light of this passage, perhaps we read the other verses of Psalm 23 through the lens of Jesus too. Maybe the place where we're asked to sit is the place where he produces abundance from fish and loaves. Maybe the still waters are the waters of life that he speaks of when he asks if anyone is thirsty. Perhaps he too then is the one who truly restores our soul. But he doesn't want us to stay where we are. He loves us too much for that. And so he chooses to lead us. Sometimes, like the video I showed, we might feel a little trepidation on the way. Unsure, is there really a way out of this place? Is this gorge going to lead to somewhere lovely? At the end of the Kerez Gorge was a beautiful waterfall and a place to rest and get a brew. Pam and I looked back from that place at the beauty and the majesty of that wonderful cathedral of God's creation. And we were glad we'd walked it. We wouldn't want to go again, mind. Perhaps that's true of many of the paths of our life. Let's offer them to God. Lord, we offer you the paths that we take and that we walk. We pray, Lord, that you would continue to walk alongside us, that you might be our way, our path, the word that's a light to our feet. Lead us to the green pastures, to the still waters of your promise, that we might know the goodness and the restoring of our soul. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen. Do have a wonderful week. Until we meet again next week, God bless.
Show me the way of the cross once again, denying myself for the love that I've gained. Everything's you now, everything's changed. It's time you had my whole life. You can have it all. Yes, I resolve to give it all. Some things must die, some things must live. Not what I can gain, but what can I give? If much is required, when much is received, then you can have my whole life. Jesus, have it all. I've given like a beggar, but lived like the rich, and crafted myself a more comfortable cross. Yet what I am called to is deeper than this. It's time you had my whole life. You can have it all. Yes, I resolve to give it all. Some things must die, some things must live. Not what can I gain, but what can I give? It much is required, when much